We have a lot of people come to us who want to get into this farming hemp. And there are some very basic things that they need to know before they run out and farm a 100-acre plot. You need to know specifically what genetics you're going to use, how you're going to germinate and get those into the ground. You need to know how you're going to irrigate, the specifics of it. You need to know how you're going to monitor pests. You need to know what products you're going to grow. What it all comes down to after you sink all this money into the dirt, or soil, as we call it, is how am I going to harvest and dry this? And if you don't get that right, all the other stuff is a waste. So you look at this big field and it's daunting because there's a lot of material. And so one option is to have a combine come in, which produces, in my mind, an inferior product because it has all this other stuff mixed in and really limits what you can do with it. You can only sell it as biomass. The value is the CBD material. And if you add the whole plant and the fiber, you're diluting that percentage, and the extractors want the high percentage. The other option is to go all labor. And in addition to the variability of speed, is you have the huge cost of 20 or 30 people in the field for 8 to 10 hours at a time. And the hybrid option, which is where we went, was to have a core group of people that we knew how fast they worked and have them using munch machines. So with the machines, you're able to let the machine set the pace so that we knew how much material was going to come in from the field every day. The metrics that we developed over the course of the season was that having 3 people per machine would do about 200 pounds an hour. I thought 2 machines for 5 acres worked very well. If you're able to produce the same with 4 to 6 people as you were with 20 to 30 people, then at the very least, you're going to save almost $2,000 a day. That's over the course of a 45-day harvest. So you're talking $60,000 to $95,000. They're paying for themselves just with the labor savings. They're just tanks. We turned them on at the beginning of the season. We turned them off at the end of the season. We cleaned them every night, but that was it. They just work. They don't vary at all. They just go. The focus was to maximize the profit. So we had to create a product that was really attractive to buyers. So we bucked everything. And all we dried was flour, and that gave us material that sold for up to 10 times what the chopped and shredded biomass would.
It's absolutely critical to have a good visual product. And we knew we would get that with the air dry. Getting it from the kiln and the mother bunker was a very pleasant surprise.
The kiln we built is based on hops technology. We get about 500 dry pounds out of it per day. Every buyer that came said that our material was beautiful, exactly what they wanted, because it's clean and there's no wood and chips and that sort of thing in it. We're going to grow 3x this coming season what we did last year, and we're just going to implement more of the same protocols and procedures that we had last year.